Can you imagine the creator of the heavens and earth? The maker of the entire universe. The person who rules the mountains, who sent the seas, who organized and orchestrated everything too big for human comprehension, comes before you and asks you, what do you want? Ask! You know, I was reading 1 Kings 3 today, and one question that never stops to amaze me stumped me. Here was God, the author of a statement. He said, what do you want? Ask! You know, in many of our childhood fantasies, you find the story of Aladdin and the lamp. Many of us fantasize about the possibility of ever coming to a day where you can get somebody who asks you for 3 wishes. And it's a genie in a bottle. It can't even get better than this. Solomon had that chance. If you got that chance, what will you ask for? If I got that chance, what will I ask for? Many of us, all of our unmet wishes, unmet needs, our empty desires, are the things we pour out on God. Somebody says, I'll ask God, can you give me 10 more wishes? Unable to even exhaust what you want in one wish. Not Solomon. Solomon realized something very interesting that I think is missing on a lot of people in church today. And I think you need to recollect, you know, get back to base and understand what the real deal is. First of all, we find that God responded to Solomon based on Solomon's worship. We find in scriptures defined a God that has emotions, a God that has the capacity to regret, a God that has the capacity to be excited. And God was excited. God saw what Solomon did and asked him, what do you want? Solomon had a blank check. How did he cash it? Solomon threw the check back at God and said, God, I don't know the beginning of this story. I'm not here because of my goodness. I'm here because there's something you're doing. You chose my father and you granted my father his wish by ensuring he had his son on the throne. Now I'm here, too young, too inexperienced, too incapable of doing your wish, your will, your command. All I ask of you, God, make me able to do what you set me aside to do. And God, Bible says, God was excited. Message version says, this excited the master God. And God looked at him and said, what? You have not asked for wealth. You have not asked for things. You have not asked for what you need for yourself. You have asked for my will. He said, I will give you everything. Do you know the version of that prayer today? The version of that prayer today is that when God wakes you up in the middle of the night and asks you, what do you want? Your answer should read like this. God, I'm not the beginning of this story. The work began with my father, Jesus Christ. You saved him. You gave him an opportunity to save the world, to connect me into God's friendship. And because you have saved me, you have given me a mandate to save all these people who need to hear about you, who need to know about you, to connect them to you as well. My responsibility is to make people your friend so that you can save them. God, give me a listening ear. Give me wisdom that I'm able to engage the world around me and connect them to you. That's the kind of prayer that excites God. When God sees that your desire is to do his will. I hope you find it. And when the blank check gets presented to you, when you do something amazing to God that makes God ask you, ask what you want. I pray you will not ask for those things that will make him lock the door. God bless you.